Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nossos programas oferecem vários idiomas. Acesse suprememastertv.com/schedule.
हमारे कार्यक्रम पेश किए जाते कई भाषाओं में कृपया देखें suprememastertv.com/schedule.
我们的节目提供多种语言，请看 suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Rancangan kami menawarkan banyak bahasa. Sila kunjungi suprememastertv.com/katabanschedule.
برامجنا متوفرة بالعديد من اللغات. يرجى زيارة suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Наша программа предлагает много языков. Пожалуйста, посмотрите suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Acara kami menyediakan banyak bahasa. Silakan lihat suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Because this is a very secret mantra, and the Buddha used that to rescue Ananda and also maybe in the future being. That's why they're all ready to protect it.
Please continue watching to find out more.
Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Today's episode will be presented in English with subtitles in Arabic, Oasis, also known as Vietnamese, Bulgarian, Chinese, Czech, English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Spanish, Telugu, and Thai. Прекрасно е да ви видим, почитаеми зрители. Казвам се Злата и съм от Пловдив в живописната България. Вашето безценно съществуване е със сигурност съкровище, дарено ни от Бог. Република България се намира в Югоизточна Европа. Известна е като средище на природни красоти, с разнообразни девствени пейзажи, като дълги крайбрежия, златни пясъчни плажове и високи планини. Един от природните паркове има над 60 планински върха, издигащи се над 2500 метра височина, с чиста планинска вода, течаща надолу към езерата. България е също така дом на повече от 550 целебни минерални извора, за които се твърди, че имат специални, възстановяващи здравето свойства. Главна религия в България е източното православие, с богата традиция в историята. Много величествени манастири могат да се видят и в страната. Например, Рилският манастир, който е обект на световното наследство на образователната, научна и културна организация на Обединените нации – ЮНЕСКО. Привилегия е да споделим поглед към красивата България с вас, дружелюбни зрители. Молим се Бог да изпълни живота ви с благословие и духовно израстване. Повече от 30 години върховният учител Чинхай озарява нашия свят с божественото си учение. Като един напълно просветлен учител, тя предава метода за медитация Куанин на онези, които желаят незабавно да открият божествената природа в себе си и за един живот да постигнат вечно освобождение от кръга на преражданията. Методът Куанин се е практикувал от всички просветлени учители, като Буда, Конфуций, Гуру Нанък, Исус Христос, Лао Цзъ, Господ Кришна, Господ Махавира, пророк Мохамед, мир на душата му и много други. Тя подчертава, че ако винаги помним Бог, служим безкорисно на другите и следваме законите на Вселената, ще постигнем най-висшия си потенциал като хора и наистина ще разберем своята цел на Земята. Върховният учител Чинхай е изключителен жив пример на състрадание и редовно изпраща материална и финансова помощ, както и любовта си на бежанците, бездомните, пострадалите от природни бедствия и други нуждаещи се от помощ. Върховният учител Чинхай е дълбоко благодарна на възлюбения Бог за цялата финансова помощ, утеха и подкрепа за пострадалите и нуждаещите се и или за всяка добра кауза през годините, като скромен съд за неговото или нейното, неутрален термин за него или нея, състрадание и любов към ценните му и деца. Върховният учител Чинхай получава подкрепа и любов от различни организации, медии, правителства и отделни личности, както и много награди от тях, като наградата за мир Гуси през 2006 година, смятана за Нобеловата награда за мир на Изтока, наградата за световно духовно водачество през 1994 година, наградата Махавир през 2008 година. 22 февруари и 25 октомври са обявени за Ден на Върховният учител Чинхай, почетен гражданин на Съединените щати и тъй нататък, и удостоявана през годините с множество други награди и почести за изключителната си благотворителна и хуманитарна дейност. Извиняваме се, че не можем да покажем много други награди и почести, поради липсата на място и време. Истински глас в защита на красивите ни приятели животните, върховният учител Чинхай насърчава мирното и любящо хранене на растителна основа и предрича, наред с пребуждането на човечеството, за светостта на всички форми на живот. Един мирен и славен, изцяло вегански свят, в който животни и хора живеят в блаженна хармония. Инициативите за разпространяване на веганската тенденция са разнообразни и включват раздаване на флаера «Алтернативен начин на живот», международните вегански ресторанти «Лавин Хът», компании за вегански хранителни продукти, изделия от веганска кожа, Supreme Master Television, както и редовни разговори с влиятелни лидери на правителствата и медиите, участие в телевизионни конференции за климатичните промени и т.н. Дали сме осъзнати за това или не, усилията й имат огромно влияние върху глобалното осъзнаване за начин на живот, който е в хармония с животните и как това доброжелателно съществуване може да донесе дълготраен мир сред народите и да спаси планетата ни от климатичните промени и бедствията. През годините върховният учител Чинхай е пътувала по целия свят, от Америките до Африка, от Европа до Океания и е изнасила стотици лекции пред обществото и пред учениците си на разнообразни духовни теми. Днес сме благословени да представим една от тези проникновени лекции, озаглавена Сурангама сутра – четирите ясни и непроменими инструкции за чистота, заключение и установяване на място за пробуждане, част 8 от 8, в между учителя и учениците, изнесена на английски на 24 декември 2018 година.
Let's see if the Buddha say anymore. Ananda, if any one of the monks' precept transmitting masters or any one of the other monks practicing with him is not pure, then the Bodhimanda as described will not be successful. Even if you don't sleep for 3 months, even if you're pure, you find all the white cow and the dung and the grass and the whatever you do, you know, more, the Buddha described more work to do, but I thought, oh, yeah, it's impossible, so forget that, I just read some for you, and you already think impossible, okay. Therefore, the Buddha said, even then, if the bhikkhu, you know, the monk who transmitted the precepts to this ever sincere seeker, if he's not pure, then you're doomed. You just work for nothing. Oh, it's that difficult. Not just that, okay, I just don't sleep 3 weeks and I find the cow and I do this and do that, as the Buddha said, then I'm fine. Who knows if the bhikkhu give you the precept is pure or not pure. He could do that maybe because he likes to do it, because he thinks he's pure, because he thinks he's worthy, you know? Who knows, maybe his thought is not pure. Therefore, even if you have all that from one of the monks, so the other precept to you, you can never be sure. This is the problem. All right, got that? Okay. So after 3 weeks, Buddha still talking now. After 3 weeks, one sits upright still, and your job not done yet after 3 weeks, okay? Not sleeping, still not. After 3 weeks, one sits upright and still for 100 days more. Oh, dear God. Oh, ay, ay, ay. I thought after 3 weeks it's already kind of, oh, you know, incredible. Marathon, feast, 3 weeks, non-stop, no sleep, doing all this already, and still sit another 100 days. My God, you should be always choose your birth whenever a living master is born. So that when you grow up, your time, your age, you come of age and you can go and grab this master and quick. Not doing all this. I don't think I can. I honestly tell you, not me, okay? Not 3 weeks non-sleep and doing all this outer performance and 100 more days. How long is 100 days? 3 months? 3 months plus. Okay. Those with sharp faculties will not arise from their seats and will become Srotapatamabana. Yeah, mean one of the non-return. Okay? Right. Although their bodies and minds have not attained the ultimate fruition of sagehood, not yet, not the highest, but already something on the way. Yeah. They know for certain, beyond exaggeration, that they will eventually accomplish Buddhahood. Yeah, they already on the way, after all that and 100 days. You have asked, the Buddha said to Ananda, you have asked how the Bodhimanda is established. This is the way it is done. Ananda bowed at the Buddha's feet and said, after I left the home life, I rely on the Buddha's affectionate regard because I sought erudition. I still have not been certified to the unconditioned, meaning Buddha has not said that he's already, you know, an arhat. Yeah, I told you. When I encounter that Brahma heaven mantra, I was captured by the deviant spell. Though my mind was aware, I had no power to free myself. You understood?
No.
No, okay. Then I have to use my calendar talk again. What is a Brahma heaven mantra? Ananda went out begging for food. And these prostitute, because they have magical power in their family, okay? She has magical power also. She used a Brahma heaven mantra, meaning that within the three worlds, this is the highest mantra, most powerful. No one can resist. She used that to seduce Ananda. And then he was like, blur and dazed. So he just followed her into bedroom. And then she did what she wanted to do with him until he almost gone. But luckily, because he has been with the Buddha, very close to the Buddha. He was the Buddha's attendant day and night, every day. And he was pure, at least so whenever he was, yes. And of course, he has been with the Buddha with many incarnations, not just this time. Always being his close attendant or his nearby acquaintance, his family, etc., etc., even in the animal's kingdom. So he remembered the Buddha last minute. He prayed, Buddha, please help me. I'm falling. And then the Buddha came, or he sent, came and recite other kind of mantra to counter this, to oppose this powerful mantra. Then, of course, Ananda is free and he run. He run back, forget his bowl, food, whatever he want to do. Run back. So that's why he said here that when I encounter that Brahma heaven mantra from the prostitute, yeah, I was captured by the deviant spell, though my mind was aware, but I had no power to free myself. That powerful. Even a Buddha disciple had to succumb to that power of that spell. Very powerful, because Brahma heaven is the highest heaven in the three worlds. So if they know that mantra, then they can use it and master it, then no one in the physical body will be able to resist and escape. Lucky for Anand, because he was always with the Buddha, life after life, and always doing good things. With the Buddha or without the Buddha. He was always virtuous, moral, good physical humans or devas or animals. So because of that, he can even in such a day's situation mesmerize spirit. He still can remember the Buddha and pray to his master for help. Otherwise, he's doomed, finished. So he said, continue. I had to rely on Manjushri Bodhisattva to liberate me. That means the Buddha sent Manjushri immediately there and then free Ananda. So he said, although I was blessed by the first come one spiritual mantra of the Buddha summit and imperceptibly received its strength, I still have not heard it myself. The Buddha sent Manjushri to bring this Buddha summit mantra, much higher than the Brahma heaven mantra, to free Anand. Yes. Although the Buddha told him that, yeah, that because of that mantra for Manjushri, so he's free. But he doesn't hear it yet himself. The Manjushri just went there and do it. But of course, inside, you know, just like you recite the five holy names inside and somebody get benefit. But that person know it because you told him, but he never heard it himself, okay? So, same. Ananda said he has not heard that mantra from the Buddha's summit, yes. So I only hope that the greatly compassionate one will proclaim it again to kindly rescue all the cultivators in this assembly and those of the future who undergo the turning wheel so that they may become liberated in body and mind by relying on the Buddha's secret sounds. Now, at that moment, everyone in the great assembly bow as one together at one, just bow down together, and stood up, waiting to hear the thirst come one's secret divisions and phrases. At that time, 100 brilliant rays sprang from the mouth of the flesh of the crown of the world honor one's head. 1,000 petal precious lotus arose from amidst those rays. Upon the precious flower sat at the thirst come one's transformation. From the crown of that Buddha's head, in turn, 10 beams of light shone forth, each composed of 100 rays of precious light. Every one of those glowing rays shone on lands as many as the sands of the 10 Ganges rivers. Why, throughout empty space, there were Vajra secret traces, spirits, each holding aloft a mountain and wielding a pestle. Just to show their power, it don't mean much, okay? At that request, you know, of the Buddha, a secret mantra, all the Vajra god, those who uphold, guarding the Dharma, and all those, they already standing ready, each one holding a mountain and a pestle. It's just their position, ready to protect the Dharma, to protect the Buddha's secret teaching. Okay? So they're all ready. The great assembly, gazing upward, felt fearful admiration and sought the Buddha's kind protection. Because when the Buddha protectors are ready in their position, they can destroy anything. Anyone who is not pure, anyone who has a bad intention towards the Buddha or the Buddha's teaching, they are ready. That's why they hold the mountain and pestle, ready to crush anyone, any being who's not respectful, who's not pure. Because this is a very sacred, secret mantra, and the Buddha used that to rescue Ananda, and also maybe in the future being. That's why they're all ready to protect it. Yeah? That's why the assembly, who are kind of not yet strong in spiritual position and level, they're so scared, fearful, and they ask the Buddha to protect them. Because these are Vajra, Vajra gods they are fearful looking. Now holding big mountain and pestle ready to attack anyone or crush anyone. So the assembly, not just monks and nuns or bodhisattva, but the assembly with the dragon and those ghosts and demons and all that good ones, and they're still fearful because they know they're not up to anything, up to any standard to protect themselves. In case the Vajra gods want to crush them, because they look too fearful, so big and giant, holding big mountain and pestle, and it's not a small one like the golf stick, yeah? Big, you know, and mountain holding, ready. So they seek the Buddha's protection, and single-mindedly they listen as the thus come one in the light at the invisible appearance on the crown of the Buddha's head proclaim the spiritual mantra. That spiritual mantra is more than 10 pages long. From 173 to 191. How much is that? More than 10 pages, for sure. Yeah, I was right. You don't need it, okay? Number one, you have your protection, okay? You have your master power protection. Number two, it is translated. It is translated into Chinese phonetic, and I can't guarantee if it works. It might work if you're really sincere, of course, but it's 20 pages long. If you keep reciting it, maybe it works. You want me to recite it? No. No need, huh? Okay. Whew, it takes a long time to recite. Maybe another time if I have to, okay? If it's good for you. Maybe another time. I will ask the Buddha whether or not I have enough power to recite it for you, okay? Not just the words, but you have to have this kind of inside power to recite it, even if it's translated into just phoneticized Chinese. Got that? Okay. All right. The Buddha prays this secret mantra, okay? Very, very much. But I think we end it here now. Tomorrow we continue. But maybe with the mantra, maybe not. Maybe with a mantra, maybe with another one, because I have promised you something else. I didn't promise a mantra. Imagine, I don't know how long it takes the Manjushri to recite this mantra while Ananda was in the helpless situation. But Manjushri pronounced the mantra probably, you know, quietly, but it affects immediately and wake Ananda out of this bewitched slumber. And Ananda ran back to the Buddha with Mantachi daughter trailing behind. Wow, what a scene, huh? What a scenery, it's like movies, yeah? Come back here, and complain to the Buddha, give Ananda back to me, he's mine. Okay, it's 12 o'clock already. Well, your mind can only take so much at a time. So even though you're interested, you should digest this. And then we continue next day, huh? Tonight I will sleep in a tent like you. I will enjoy it. Fresh air and all. Thank you for being so polite and generous with your clapping. Your clapping. Okay. Next time, any unnecessary question or not urgent question, please wait until I finish, okay? is better for all of you, okay? You are not alone in the assembly. You are in the midst of 10,000 plus people. Please consider others before you. That is the minimal courtesy and minimal selflessness. Yeah? And if you listen to the teaching of the sage, even from by time gone, it's good for you, okay? Instead of just thinking of one single question, which it wasn't that important, wasn't really necessary to us in the middle of that. You should respect the Buddha teaching and continue listening. That's the best, okay? If any question, there is time to ask, okay? Anything to do with the subject is better. To keep it the energy, you know, clean, pure, concentrated, and blessing flowing, huh? Next time, remember that, all of you, okay? A good night. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yonder. So tender and mild. Holy night, silent night. Holy night, silent night. See you tomorrow, okay? <音楽><音楽>圣诞节快乐! Happy Christmas! Yan Chen Vui Bé! Merry Christmas! Love you! 爱你! Love, 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 love! Love you! Love you, love you! Love you. Love you so much. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Yan Shen Vui Vẻ. Frohe Weihnachten. Joyous Noel. Joyous Noel, Joyous Noel, for why not? Merry Christmas, nhân sinh vui vẻ, năm mới mình giỏi.
Доброжелателни зрители! Оценяваме присъствието ви за днешния епизод, озаглавен Сурангама Сутра – четирите ясни и непроменими инструкции за чистота, заключение и установяване на място за пробуждане, част 8 от 8, в между учителя и учениците. Следва, не е късно да получиш просветление.
Въпроси и отговори.
Част 5 от 5. Слова на мъдростта. Веднага след важните новини. Моля, останете с Supreme Master Television за още позитивни предавания. Нека щедрите ви сърца, добри думи и състрадание
бъдат в служба на човечеството. Benevolent viewers, we appreciate your company for today's episode entitled The Surangama Sutra, The Four Clear and Unalterable Instructions on Purity, Conclusion and Establishing a Place for Awakening, Part 8 of 8, on Between Master and Disciples. Coming up next, it's not too late to get enlightenment.
Questions and Answers,
Part 5 of 5, on Words of Wisdom, right after Noteworthy News. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television for more positive programming. May your generous hearts, kind speech and compassion be of service to humanity.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/DMD.